We've seen past U.S. presidents make threats, but never quite as bluntly as this.
North Korea best not make any more threats to the United States. They will be met with fire and fury like the world has never seen. He has been very threatening beyond a normal statement. And as I said, they will be met with fire, fury, and frankly, power, the likes of which this world has never seen before.
This from the man who alone holds the nuclear codes, capable of launching one of the largest nuclear arsenals in the world. He was responding to this story in the Washington Post, alleging the Defense Intelligence Agency believes North Korea can now put a nuclear warhead on an intercontinental ballistic missile, basing its report on anonymous sources without actually seeing the classified document. It reads, quote, "The assessment states in an excerpt read to the Washington Post, the assessment's broad conclusions were verified by two U.S. officials familiar with the document." They don't say just how confident the intelligence agency is that the information is accurate, or if any of the other 16 American intelligence agencies agree.
I want to ask our team in the booth, our control room, to pop back up that schematic.
Still, the news was not met with any skepticism by U.S. cable news networks. It just quickly became an undisputed fact.
Talk to me about what they might be thirsty to hit first.
The one thing that is clear is that the response from the Trump administration has been anything but. We've seen the U.S. Secretary of State say that he's willing to negotiate with North Korea. The U.S. ambassador to the United Nations said the time for talk is over. The CIA director hinted that the U.S. was looking for regime change in North Korea. On the campaign trail, the president said that the fact that he was unpredictable, well, that was an asset. We're about to find out in a very high-stakes test if he's right. Patty Culhane, Al Jazeera, Washington.